We'll be right back. Finish him. I'm recording.
We're streaming and recording.
We're streaming and recording. We're streaming and recording. Oh, yes. I'm on the damn.
Dust. And the game audio was okay?
Yeah.
Oh, thank you, sir.
All right. So we got HCP. He gets the first hit with the back one. We got heavy weapons jacks. You don't see these anymore.
You don't. Probably because his cancels
a lot of
suck.
People say, yeah, his cancels do suck. I'm not a cancel person. I don't play cancel characters. Although I do think Hellfire is the best cancel, in my opinion. But everyone
you think Hellfire is the best cancel character?
Yeah, well, that's my opinion. I know a lot of people say A-List is the best.
I think Devorah is the best.
Devorah is up. Devorah is good. She had multiple top 8 occasions, but so does A-List.
A-List, you don't really see a lot of A-List at high-level play. I think that's just because of the players that choose to play him.
They're not, like, smart Johnny Cage players.
I don't know.
ATP got eliminated by 2 A-Lists at EVO, actually.
Well, that's because ATP is a scrub.
ATP is a scrub. Look at this scrubby Kodo.
He's working some scrub stuff, though, on Rage
yeah,
right now.
Yeah, he is. Oh,
good block. That's going to be punished.
Block. ATP gets the round. Round 1, game 1, going to ATP.
Sorry.
Go ahead. No, go ahead. Take it. All right. Rage doing his jack stuff. Does Rage know how to cancel?
He should know how to cancel.
I mean, right? He's playing heavy weapons. Either that or he's playing variationless.
We haven't seen him in like 7 weeks.
That's true. Let's hope Rage knows how to cancel because, whoa, HP going with the gimmicks. Ooh, the shimmy with the bazooka. He gets it with the EX or the regular overhead punch. Back 1-2 or is that forward 1-2? I don't remember. I don't know the jack
I don't
combos.
Know the input. Yeah, it doesn't matter. They're mids. That's all you
the
need
mids,
to know.
They're the mids. Superman
why is
punch?
He waking up with dash punch? He has 3 bars.
No.
Why are you doing this?
He could have woke up X-ray, probably sitting around.
I mean, he just needs more better footsies, better neutral play. He needs to use his bars a little bit better.
All right, so HCP takes the first round, or first game. Rage, you know, needs to make some adjustments. Staying with heavy weapons, and you know, I'm not like I said, I don't see him doing cancels. He's basically playing variationless. Jacks.
Variationless jacks with rocket launcher.
With some rockets, yeah. Because he's not doing any cancels. He's like, yeah, it's a basic 30 combo, 30% combo. So, and HP gets to throw.
Yeah, right now, this is death for Rage. He will die right here.
He is dead.
He is dead right now.
We might as well just fast forward. Just
put the counter down to 0.
Oh, 1-1-1.
Put his life down to 0. Good jump by ATP.
Oh, he was.
Blanche,
he's trying to bazooka Blanche, but it
save
doesn't work.
Save the brutal, please.
Oh,
save the brutal.
Breaks. Why did he break? That was questionable. ATP's just gonna stand in the sunlight. Oh no, he's gonna look. See, no cancel.
Yeah, I think Rage. I don't know. I don't know. I don't know what to say.
I didn't know what Rage. And he gets hit. 1-1-1 gets hit with that overhead. He keeps going for that on knockdown, but just. HP's not falling for it. Keeps jumping out of it. And Koldo does have a great jump one.
Rage really needs to work on adapting to this matchup
doesn't
a little quicker.
Doesn't armor break the overhead sword.
Yeah, he was a little too far away for that. Needs to talk to Poser Paul about that. We did see this set earlier in
with
the tournament. Earlier
was
tonight.
Was it JD and...
It was JD and Poser
and
Paul.
Poser Paul, you're right. Poser Paul doing pump up and a wrestler. Rage doing... So we saw all 3 variations of Jax tonight.
Very rare. Very rare.
You know who we don't see tonight? Melina.
Who? Melina?
Or Alien.
That is true.
I haven't seen an Alien or Melina.
That is very true.
Austin's known for the... Or Tex is known for the cult...
Fatality him!
The fans screaming for the fatality.
I just want it.
All right, so we got...
We're not playing Street Fighter. I want to see blood.
All right, so we got some Xbox issues. PS4 dominant, obviously.
Right back.
All right, so Rage switched. I believe he went to Sector. I'm not sure, but I want to say I saw Sector. Excuse me. And he starts with neutral jump, and it is Sector. War God versus Sector. Jump one. Oh, and but it doesn't convert. And we got ATP.
No. Next time.
Yeah, next month when you come back. Oh, overhead, no. And Koto, ATP does his Koto combo. Toki says that doesn't work, that's just shenanigans for Koto, but HCP still does it. Shout out to Toki Dallas. Dallas? Right? No, I really don't know where they're from. I just know they're from Texas. Texas boys. The back 1-2-2 sword. The 24% for Coltal. Plus frames. No shenanigans this time. Ooh, out of the low sword. And you see he gets a combo. Oh, the plus, but he doesn't get up rockets. Nope. It gets the down two. Nope. Sector is in the corner. He's in trouble. The only armor move he has is he can't combo off it. And I believe Kotal can actually armor out of it himself. ATB is very good. He could probably read the armor right before he comes out. Oh, the full screen X-ray. Oh my god. ATP, no mercy, goes for the X-ray for the win. And what does he do? The bear hug? He does. Are you still in it? They can't?
All right, oh, yeah, Junior. I see. Yeah, this is me, Regenerate 2 on commentary. I'm already out of the local.
Yeah, Xbox is lagging again.
We have Mr. Nauge. That is really unplayable. He brought his Xbox, but it's super laggy. So we're going to try and get him on stream next.
All right, so we got ATB in right now. He is on Zubzerl as Hensar playing Grandmaster. Not his main, but, you know, it is a better variation. Ooh, and he gets hit by the clone. And, oh, but he drops a combo.
And Johnny, you guys will play on stream next when they're done.
And he blocks over his sword, and it's punishable. Doesn't do the clone for bar. What is that, 29% clone? And oh my gosh,
Hensar winning?
Beautiful. I've never seen that before. Hensar has Kotal in the corner. He throws him before the. Oh, but EX sword. Oh, and
good
he blocks
block.
It
he's going to take it.
He can't take it. Yep, Sub-Zero. Or Hensar takes the first round. Sub-Zero has Kotal in the corner. Kotal really can't do anything unless he uses bar.
Ooh, he hit him.
Oh, he hit him, but he doesn't convert.
I don't know if he can convert off that, though.
Oh, he tries to EX clone out of that, but he still gets hit by the sword.
He gets hit by the
low. Gets hit again. It's clones. He can throw it in front of him. Just be ballsy about it. Nope. Oh, and he gets the conversion.
Good conversion. ATP is so solid right now.
All right. Low sword. Gets hit by it. Clone. Wake up, clone. Oh, he blocks the slide. He fooled me once. Shame on you. Fooled me twice. Shame on me. Doesn't fall for it this time.
Fool me three times. It's more than a 50-50.
Agreed. And ATB looks like he went all the way back to. Oh no, he switched corners. Oh, two. And no, he wasn't low enough to the
that
ground.
That is so unfortunate. This is why I don't play Sub-Zero.
Oh, but this should be a lot of damage. Oh, but he drops it again. You know what? I think this is why Hensar doesn't like the Grandmaster match. He's not comfortable with it. He prefers Grandmaster. He knows the combos. He knows what to do.
Hensar can still take the CS. Three bars.
Oh,
yes! He gets the wake up X-ray.
That should
I love
be
it.
The game. Yes. Hensar takes the first.
It was
game.
A guess. It was a 50-50. Because it's a counter. So you either, HTB either had to go in or he had to not go in.
Let me update the scores real quick.
Yeah,
Hensar is up one game.
Hensar's actually up. Last time these guys played in tournament that we saw recorded anyway, that I was here. It was a mop by ATP.
Yeah, ATP's been on a roll with these weeklies. The only person that stopped him so far was Mr. Nauge.
Mr. Nauge stopped ATP last week.
Yes,
correct?
And I think Senior Abrams stopped him.
Senior Abrams stopped
ATP
the week before.
Yeah, he won 2 weeks already. Yeah, he's won 2 weeks.
Abrams, yeah.
All right, jump kick doesn't work. Gets the uppercut, the overhead. Oh, EX slide. Goes for the clone. Oh, my gosh. Doesn't stop the interactable.
It's the game. The game is laggy.
Oh, yeah, because KI is working fine. Yo, because KI is bomb. Yo, we're going to have a side KI tournament. 30 minutes. Nah, just kidding. All right. We got a Kotal. ATP takes the first round of the second game, but does not stop being Grandmasters of Zero Hensar. Corner carry. Gets a slide. No, he was too close. Yo, let's see if we can do it. And he gets it this time.
He gets the ice clone.
About 38%.
It's always the big question.
The combo.
That was a really bad drop.
Nice chip, though. That,
can't punish.
Oh, nope. Backdash doesn't work.
Oh,
he's
just dunking on him.
Froze a dunk. 16%.
I want to see some disrespect between these players. Brutal. I want to see brutalities. I want to see fatalities. I want to see teabagalities.
Oh, looks like. Can ATP bring this back? Will he make Hensar burn? Oh, he makes him break. I don't know if I agree with that. He's only going to do about 24%.
Ooh, that just hit him. That was crazy.
Yeah. right, down four. Man, that Kodo down four is godlike.
I was wondering, maybe if you could uninstall the game and reinstall it. But you probably.
Oh, and he jumps over the EX over his sword. Gets the clone, does a punish though. Oh, and he breaks the EX sword combo. And no, but doesn't fall for it this time. Alright, no. The slice. Oh, EX wake EX a clone gets Kodo, but he drops the combo. Oh my god! That was godlike. I've never seen that done before. And the brutal!
The brutality! Yes!
Came
back. Oh, his head fell off.
Henzar is on 2-0 against ATP.
This is looking really
good
for Henzar.
That was crazy. You missed it.
I'm so excited.
ATP EX sword. And since there's a gap, Henzar EX clone. ATP thought that he got the EX sword, so he ran into the clone. It was good. It was really good.
That
Henzar
was really smart.
Yes.
Yeah. Really
Henzar
smart
knows
stuff.
What he's doing. Very smart player. And he is on the verge of taking ATP out 3-0. Mm. But ATP has him in the corner right now. This is looks like to be ATP's round. He's trying to keep him there. Blocks the low sword. Does Henzar
ice clone?
Anything?
No.
No clone? No.
Well, the
jumps
thing is,
after cut.
If he does a block string into clone, I think ATP is able to react to that and use his armor.
He can, but he would have to waste the bar.
Well,
and
yeah,
right,
but
right now, it doesn't
matter. It's a bar
matter,
well worth it.
Oh, backdash. And it looks like Henzar is now on the offense.
Ooh,
oh,
he hit him.
He gets hit, but he doesn't convert.
Yeah, well, it's a tough hit confirm on that second hit.
Yep, and ATP chips him out. It is ATP takes the first round of the third game.
Can this should not face Henzar.
Henzar is looking calm and controlled as usual. It cancels the drill, punish the sword? Not with a slide? Not fast enough?
I'm not sure. I'm really not sure.
Oh,
I think he can punish with slide.
Oh, he missed. Jumps over the ice clone, ice ball. Does a back 1-2-2 again, 21%. Now Henzar's in the trouble. Oh, he jumps over the EX sword, but he doesn't convert again. And he throws it out the corner. That's really weird. Oh, the drill is very strong in the corner. He's
as long as he gets the grab, though.
And good, a nice 14%.
Yep.
Oh,
nice!
Gets hit with the low, double low, gets the EX.
So now Henzar is back in the corner.
Combo again.
He's got corner position. He gets hit by the low.
He gets the clone out.
No,
that's
so bad.
EX, oh, no.
Why is he doing this? Oh, he gets hit by the low again.
Let's see if he can take the round. He's very close. Shatters, no. The clone again, yep.
He's just trying to get.
Oh, that was nice.
He might have been trying to use armor, but it just didn't come out.
No. Not that time. Jumps over the ice ball, but he has enough time to block. Ooh,
good.
Very
armor
nice. Very
through.
Nice. Very nice. Oh, this should be big damage. Oh, he doesn't. That's the second time he's dropped that combo.
Hollow, please.
Henzar's see, Henzar composed themselves. They are even. They look like even alive, even in bars.
Ooh, and good punish.
Nice.
On the uppercut.
16%. Oh,
so unfortunate.
Can Henzar take. Oh, I would have. Oh,
there it is.
No.
See, on
he
reaction,
it,
ATP can do it easily.
Throws a clone. Oh, and he gets hit by it. Oh,
fatality, that man!
It.
Brutality!
Nah, he and the faction kill.
They're about
the
to
disrespect
punch each other.
With faction kill.
About to punch each other here.
It's like, oh, Dimbowski? Do you know who that is? He said you suck.
That's Dylan.
I don't know their Twitch names, bro. They're not the same Twitch names.
Dylan, I do suck, my bad.
Oh, so we got ATP commentating with me. What's going on, ATP? ATP, he's not feeling very well today, guys. He is hungover.
I'm fine. I lost because I lost. Henzar outplayed me.
Yes, Henzar was, he was a very, very beautiful set. But it looks like we're going in. Mr. Knowledge versus JD. First game, and I have the names backwards. Mr. Knowledge is Quan Chi.
Yeah, Knowledge is a Quan A.
And JD is the War God Loyalist.
By the way, stream, let us know how we sound.
No, they said we sound fine now.
Oh, they did?
Yeah.
Flawless victory, actually. So JD used to play Quan, so.
Back when, before he got his nerfs, right? Or did he just
no,
stop?
He
just
the
dropped.
Before the big set of nerfs.
Oh, okay. I knew he played Quan, I just thought he switched because he was because of the nerfs. And I figured if there's going
to
be more nerfs for Kodo, he's going to switch again.
He wanted to play because he wanted to play more Rushdown.
Oh, okay.
Kodo's definitely. But anyway, now it's got the corner right now.
He's
no bar. JD's getting mixed up right
Well, let's see after. Let's see next week to see if he can.
There, he actually does that to keep him standing, but he drops the combo. JD has a chance, but no dice. Now, first blood.
Now takes that first game very convincingly.
Where's the? I'm gonna look at the bracket real quick. Is this winners?
He has it. Yeah, this is the winners.
So yeah, this is winners. Oh, okay, winner of this was Abrams.
Yes, and the winner of that is in winners finals with Henvar.
All right, some zoning right now.
How many people do we have today? 12.
That was nice turnout. But he misses it.
This is plus frame, but his backdash. Quan has a very good backdash.
I found out
that when I every time I play Mr. Knowledge, I get bodied. I'm not gonna lie, I get 3-0'd every time. I have no answer. Well, I try to go for the uppercut, doesn't work.
You need to figure out how to deal with Kotal or Quan zoning and then where his gaps are. He has gaps.
Yes, it's a second.
He's running up lowing right now.
Oh.
You were muted?
Yeah, I was muted. Nobody knew.
It's like I was talking to myself.
Nobody
now.
Knew.
Like,
whoa.
My bad.
All right, we're still good.
Yeah, we're still good.
The stream is still alive.
Yes. And
I was muted the whole time. Why he charges that back too?
Does it make a plus or no?
It makes it plus two, but there's no reason to do it. It's way too long.
So Mr. Knowledge is teasing him. Basically.
No, it was an accident. So he's gonna get a full combo here. Neutral dump.
NJP needs to be nerfed.
No, it doesn't. He goes like, low again, goes plus frames.
Oh, but he armors out of it. Let's see if JD can get something going here.
Doesn't do the corner switch, though. Disagree with that. Plus.
Gets the plus frames.
Nice backdash, but.
Double backdash, actually. Yeah. Then he jumps back.
Okay, so he's going to push him full screen, or is he going to rush him down still?
I think he's going to push him.
Oh, he's going to do the reset. There's the reset.
The overhead.
That's going to be the round.
That should be the round.
Oh, he resets again. All right, whatever.
Is this going for
I guess he saw the breaker. I didn't see that. 2-0 Mr. Nowsh.
These are very
JD going
right
to character select, I believe. I don't think he's going to switch, but he needs time to think it out. So let me check the loser's bracket right now. So Ryujin's out. Damn, he went 0-2. Rest in peace. Rest in pepperonis. Poser Powell is out.
Powell.
Magnum is out. Dust plays the loser of this.
And then I play the winner of that. All right, so JD, going back
Alien.
In, let's see if he can make some adjustments, see what
Should
he can do.
Should I play Alien?
He is in winners finals. I mean, he is in winners, so if he does lose this, he does have a
Wait,
chance. Should I play Alien?
Should I play Alien?
If you want. I mean.
It's the last day, right?
Right? Make sure you go out with a bang.
Stream, should I play Alien for the last bang? The last day of Alien.
And he doesn't fall for the EX overhead sword, but he's out of the corner, but looks like Mr. Knowledge is just going to put him back.
Yeah, you can jump the overhead sword a lot, actually. That's something that not a lot of people do. I mean, Kotal has anti-airs to stop you from jumping, but it's something that you can do a lot more often.
Overhead again.
Oh, that
he
broke.
The armor. Wow.
Yeah. It's actually not as fast as you would think. Nice. Yeah, there's no hit advantage on low sword. Match point, Mr. Knowledge. JD is getting frustrated by
zoning,
I think.
Convert.
I think he tried to bait out the armor, but now it doesn't bite. Going to push him away? No, he stops the breaker. JD.
If I was missing knowledge, I would have mode and broke. Yeah, just like that. Now he has no bar.
Oh, he commits.
Oh, he does.
Actually, I would have thrown him back in the corner, but all right, we'll see what happens. Plus frames. Nice
block. Oh, nice bait.
All right. This is JD's
like
time.
He
can do another
nice
plus frames. There it is.
Let's see if he falls pretty good. Oh, gets it.
Ugly combo. He actually could have done a lot more off of that.
Ugly combo, ATP says.
Well, it was.
Knows,
misses the punish.
All.
And that's going to be the round. There's nothing Quan can do. He's going to get. No, well,
no
that was
up.
Risky.
No wake up.
You just want to do the back one string in that situation. You do that neutral jump, if they're feeling themselves, they can run under you.
Okay.
But anyway, Mr. Knowsh, trying to close it out. Still a match point. Has a bar.
Oh, he gets hit with that back two.
He's going to get it there. So he might go for the reset here. He has a big life lead.
He does have a bar.
And there it is.
And he
gonna,
it.
What's going to be the mix-up? He
goes
low.
And that should be the game.
Well, he does have a breaker, so let's see if he techs the throw.
No.
Oh, he just does down two.
And that's it.
That's it.
No wake-up options.
Yeah. Oh, no, well, this one, it's probably just 6-4. He does get the wake-up scoop.
Okay.
But it's still, it can be rough.
Oh, yeah, he's going Warlock.
Wow, they both backdash at the start of the match.
the Sonic roll to get the first hit.
Yeah, he backdashed, but he was afraid to whiff punish.
Oh, he gets hit by the foot. Oh, he gets hit by the Sonic roll again. Not even jumping this time.
Okay, that's plus.
Oh, it picks it up right away.
Plus. Nice poke, but that down one doesn't give a lot of hit advantage.
Oh, he gets hit by the caught. EX.
I think he was trying to punish the
the
rune, yeah.
Back one. Nope, overhead now.
Okay. Now it's right now in a bad position. Yeah, that's gets caught.
Does it convert?
He's going to get zoned, yes. Yeah. It's hard. When Ronin gets rolling, it's hard for any character to really fight back, but that's what it is. Okay. Abram blocks. Doesn't block the rune, but now it doesn't confirm. No bar. Abram with three.
No bar. This is very, going to be very hard for him.
Yeah, if he gets in once, it'll be basically loop time.
Oh, wait.
Yeah, he tried to.
Oh,
whoa.
EX car roll.
Not a real combo, though. He just did down two.
Maybe he's trying to keep him away. I don't know.
Okay.
Senior Abram does like to keep it's like, his face with those lips. He knows Takeda. Like, the back of his hand. He's been playing Takeda day one. Started with Shiryu. Picked up Ronin.
Ronin's broke.
The double jumping fours.
Okay, Mr. Nausch trying to set something up. He gets the low. I think Abram's going to break, actually. No, he's going to hold it.
Yeah.
He's going to get the reset here.
He gets it. Oh,
there's
the throw, and that should be the round.
Yeah. It's pretty hard. That's a four-way mix-up right there. You know, you just got to guess.
All right, so it's down to the final round. Oh, that
first
one.
Look at that ridiculous string. You guys saying, ooh, it doesn't cover.
Back two is still his.
No,
yes,
that string is clearly better than back two. What are you talking about?
He still can't combo off it, though.
Doesn't matter. You knock them down, and then you get to go into loop pressure time. That's what matters. Get the hit, and then you just loop pressure on them.
I mean, okay, let's talk about Alien.
I'm not saying Alien isn't the same thing, but that string covers.
That's the only string he has. You take that away, he's down.
I'm saying just make it slightly worse.
How?
It shouldn't cover all of that and jail into everything.
Okay.
Do you not understand what I'm saying there?
What should it do?
It should just be a gap at the end.
Okay. Wasn't there a gap before?
No.
Oh,
yeah, at the very beginning
right?
There's not a gap in anything anymore.
I will agree with you. There should be a gap when the whip comes down. That's it, though.
I mean, there's got to be something. That string, look how powerful that. He can't do anything. He has to hold that. He has to hold a four-way mix-up after blocking that string. And then with Shira Ryu, it's plus 20 kunai to do it again.
Senior Abram.
And Lasher, there's a mix-up into a launcher, or it's just another plus 20 kunai. And then even when you do the one where you're like just kind of neutral or zero, you can just like neutral jump, and nobody can contest that. It's super hard.
I mean, that's why Takeda has been.
That's
winning.
Why Takeda is top five in Ronin.
Winning. Oh,
top 10
in Ronin.
Top 10 in Shira Ryu.
Oh,
and Lasher's. I had him at like A tier.
Oh, yeah, you did.
Takeda's amazing.
Yeah, but Austin's tier list is really whack.
Yeah, whatever. I don't know what you're talking about. Now it's with a big lead right now. Okay, gets the throw. But Abram has full bar again. One touch. Like we said, he can just loop pressure. And here it is.
Gets the combo going.
He's
going to
get a good damage. He's going to drop the sword. No, he's
30,
just going to.
40%.
40% for a bar into all this pressure. He's going to break.
Oh,
it's going to be confirmed.
And he does, yes.
Yeah, look at that. My goodness. And I hope that nerfed that jump four, too. Plus 80, whatever it is. Look, and this zoning is also great. I mean, it's not as good as like the top tier zoners, but it's like really still solid. It's hard.
Senior Abram has the missing knowledge.
Kicked him in the back. Wow, that was a super meaty overhead. It looked like he didn't even got up.
Oh, it doesn't connect the jump one. 4-3. Jump four.
Look at this. There's nothing. Okay, goes low.
Doesn't.
Oh, man. Now she's getting rushed down. Breaking arms. Plus. He went for a double neutral jump setup. Look at this, plus zero.
He gets that low grab.
Okay.
Let's see what he does.
Now she's going to get something. But again, like the threat of the sword on the ground.
Yeah,
he can just
EX
wake up.
Right?
Yeah, and
yeah,
then he does,
there.
Yeah.
There's the armor. Oh,
he missed it, but no whiff punish. He's going to break to survive. He's going to do random trance. Look, in this footsie range, you get to have this giant footsies and be plus/neutral and everything. It's just a little too much.
So why is he not won tournaments? since he's such a great
character. Hayate gets top three. I'm sorry, he like loses to Sonic Fox. That's literally the only people. Sonic and Foxy.
I know, he lost aliens.
Yeah, Dragon. He just loses to Dragon.
Yeah, he's still not, you know, the best character.
Look, there gets to a point where the character results don't matter as much in tournament. Sonic Fox can pick whoever he wants and mop basically 99% of the tournament scene.
99%.
Yeah.
Okay. I got.
And it's the same with Takeda and stuff like that. This is the characters that they choose, that Hayate chooses, and it just so happens that he's not. He's like the fifth best in the world. He loses to the top four players. And those are the ones that beat him. He loses to Sonic. He loses to Foxy. He loses to Scar. He loses to Dragon. That's basically all. The only people he loses. He loses to some random people every now and then.
Oh, he burns two bars. Yeah. Takes a round. But now he's in the corner.
Match point.
You watch the TWC? Or
Yeah. I mean, you can't. And also, you're basing it on results. Why isn't Aaron Black the best character in the game?
Why Aaron Black?
Sonic has won a million tournaments with Aaron Black.
That was like, he hasn't won a tournament with Aaron Black in a long ass
He almost
time.
Won EVO with Aaron
almost.
Black.
Doesn't mean
he won. The Commonwealth with Aaron Black. He won CEO with Aaron Black.
He won CEO?
Yes.
With Aaron Black?
Yes.
You're right.
He won the last TCW with Aaron Black. He won
no,
a bunch
he didn't
of things. He won the first EVO, the first and second TCW. He's
no,
won with Aaron Black.
What's his name? DJT won it with Fist of Johnny.
No, he knocked Sonic into losers.
Are you sure?
But Sonic won.
Yes. I could have sworn DJT won.
No, Sonic. No, and then he won. Sonic wins a million things with Aaron Black. All right, Aaron Black has the most tournament wins in this game. Why isn't he the best?
I feel like Alien has the most. Well, you know,
no,
right,
he doesn't.
Right. Yeah, he has, Alien has like.
Alien won one game
like,
in EVO.
Aaron Black has like a year of tournament experience.
Yeah. It's not based on what the tournament results are. To an extent. I'm not saying it's completely invalid. Obviously, there's a ton of aliens that float around in Molinas. And the reason is because they're good. The reason why you don't see any Ancestrals is because they're bad.
I saw an Ancestral on ESL.
Yeah, but that doesn't count. Online, anyone can get anywhere.
It was a Hayate.
Oh, well, he's just getting ready for the nerfs. Actually, that was ESL, so it was way before them. I was ranting.
Mr. Now just takes the game.
What? Am I playing? Oh, sorry. So anyway.
Mr. Now take a game.
Now's got a game on a 7-3. Let's go.
On
a
7-3?
Well, it's probably 6-4. I'll trust... Mr. Now.
Oh,
whoa,
wow,
that was weird.
Yeah,
he could have neutral jump punched that, actually. Something that Mr. Nash is doing is whenever he's getting his chance. Okay, yeah, that's better. He was just like poking, which can
jumping.
Be fine in some situations, but if you just poke and they block, then you lose and they go back into
again.
Looping pressure. Yeah. So he does like a jump out string, something like that. Oh, he could have punished that.
This is a bar.
Look at this, dead. Match point again, Abram. The best BLT in the world.
BLT, Mr. Nalish.
Okay, so he could actually whip punish that, but whoa, that was weird. He got hit by the kick, but he immediately got up. Oh man, he's getting footsied right now. Nice scoop. Okay, gonna reverse the whole thing here. I think Abram's gonna hold on to his bar. Yeah. Okay, but no bar on Nalish's side. That's one of the weaknesses of Warlock. You got to use the bar for the launcher. And you don't have bar for the EX runes for safety. So it's a little
What's
harder.
What's that kick on block?
I think it's like minus 10. But there's a lot of blocks done on it.
Yeah.
Ooh, he tried to bait out the armor there, actually. With the interactable. This might be it. He's going to get restood. No, he drops it.
Yeah. I think Mr. Niles would
have... Ooh, the down three. Okay, he's going to force a break. This is good.
Did he do down three to rune?
Yes.
Wow.
It's actually very good with Quan. He's going to scoop. That's the question. That's what Abram's waiting for. Doesn't whiff punish the whiff string.
Yeah, he could have at least
okay, he's going to kick him. Okay. Doesn't use the bar.
Oh, he gets hit by the...
Oh, he dodges.
Oh, nice.
That's
going
to be the round.
Doesn't
I want him to build
it.
A little bit of
doesn't
bar.
Drop it.
Okay, he tries to stay safe. Mr. Now staying alive.
One round apiece.
This D's pretty good. goes low, hit confirms. I like the way that Naush confirms that low string. If it's on block, he'll either stop it or he'll go into rune. If it's on hit, he'll always go into the full string. It's very good, actually. It makes you save bars, Quan. It's very important. But this is 40 right here. Big life deficit.
And so hard knockdown.
Oh, no whiff punish. He's backdashing a little too much.
Whoa.
If he just backdashes once, he can get a punish. He's stopping the ball roll. There
oh,
it is.
Nice.
He was waiting that for the whole time. He's going to do the reset. I actually want him to hold on to the bar. He goes for it. I don't know. This is going to be risky. He gets the mid string, builds a bar.
He did that just for chip, or?
Yeah, he does it for chip, and
so
it's safe.
Oh.
And he built the bar, so let him do some stuff.
Oh.
But now, okay, he's still alive. He's going to get one guess here. Does not guess correctly, and that's it. Yeah, that's it.
No?
He's dead. There's nothing he can do.
Oh,
he whiffed!
Commentator curse!
Abram whipped the string.
Commentator curse, you said he was dead.
He was,
delayed
dude.
The wake-up.
You literally just had to do the one string, the forward one string, and he just whiffed the whole thing.
Delayed.
He had to do the full string.
Mr. Naush being...
Oh, yeah? I messed up? I should stop talking?
Mr. Naush,
that was
with
bad.
The intelligence to
two,
stay...
2-2, and that was good, actually. He realized the whiff and did a full combo. He didn't just poke.
He delayed the wake-up,
so.
So he can whiff.
Did you win
combo.
Your match? You all right?
I don't think so.
Choking on that Kotal Kahn? That sword went deep down your throat, bro. Mmm. All right, went to character select. Like we said, he was playing a lot of ninjutsu. What'd you say? Why? Kotal or Kwan? Oh, you hate me. Damn, it's like that, bro. So wait, if you won, that means I think you play, who do you play? I don't even know who you play. Well, they're playing. And I play the winner of Izzy and...
The winner of this.
Oh, so you play the winner of that?
Them two, yeah.
So yeah, so I'll play one of these three guys.
All right, so I'm out.
No, you're not done yet. Well, how do you? You guys got to go in with confidence. I think you picked Scorpion though.
Ninjutsu.
Yeah, ninjutsu.
No, that Infernal.
Yeah. Okay. Ninjutsu, I would say is this was something I was telling people.
Oh,
nice punish on the teleport. I don't think that is punishable by teleport.
I think he was trying to figure it out.
Yeah, he just did it. But because of that, now gets the first bar. Goes low, and he goes with the confirm there. That skull is actually like plus 14.
Even on block, right?
Yeah. Well, I mean, yeah, on hit doesn't matter. It just, it works. 40%. But it's like a new way to do his mix-up.
Ooh,
nice anti-air.
Anti-air.
It's going to be the round. I don't think Abram's going to spend bar.
Unless he's ballsy,
no.
But he doesn't.
Only Sonic Fox does that. Match point, Mr. Naush. He ran it back. Let's see if he can finish it out, though. Gets him with the kick. Yeah, that forward two can be tricky. Wow, he just teleports.
It's an air teleport.
I think he was trying to do the cancel, and he just didn't have stamina.
Forward
nice blocks. Try to anti. Okay, he's getting caught low. Again, that's the option that you want to take. But then you open up these sweeps and these down fours, and they'll get to you after a while. Goes low again, plus frames. Okay, nice poke. Even though down one doesn't have a lot of hit advantage, you got to use it.
Oh, it
yeah, he does the
one.
Cancel there.
Can you cancel the air one?
Yeah, you can
okay.
Cancel all of them. So, even the EX. Okay, so now he's with
he
a good life lead. No bar,
yeah,
though.
He
nice, he's dodging right now. He's trying to get this bar desperately. He gets it there.
Oh,
that's a punish.
This
and
is, this is like Mr. Naush's game.
Well, he's going to get a breaker. No, he's going to throw him. He's still
but he
alive.
He does have a breaker.
He's still alive. Next hit will win it for him. Tries to get him at the air to air.
No grab.
This is dangerous.
Oh,
oh no.
He gets support and he converts.
Okay, so this isn't a true vortex situation, but
oh,
there's the low. Yeah, you can technically fuzzy the overhead with the 4-2, but it's tricky. Again, this isn't a true vortex situation. Blocks the overhead. That might be chip. Oh,
oh.
Wow, he just, I don't even know what string that was. He pressed one, and now takes it 3-2.
Never realize Dustin didn't go to Melina right away.
Oh, well, there might be some pride on the line here. This is loser's bracket. This is the last version with these characters in their current state.
Yep, right
so
after
we
this
patch, see how we,
Lash
how
and Gale are going to be top tier.
Yeah. Doesn't punish the overhead sword, but now he has no bar. Nice anti-air.
There's a whiff. There's a kunai.
Oh, wow, he jumps it, but no full punish on the whiff down too.
Oh.
There's the armor. That's what I've been waiting for Dust to do the whole time.
That's a nice 27%.
Yeah, I'm like, stop waking up with armor. Just use armor to interrupt stuff, you know? He's really good. He's going to spend the bar. Okay. Oh, he misses the combo, though. Yeah.
Oh, out of the air.
The second he did that, there was no way he was going to get any type of pressure. And are you just going to run everything as fast as possible? You're going to run everything as fast as possible?
Wait, okay. You're going to... Oh, because let's say winner's finals?
Yeah, he's doing it as fast as possible.
Okay, so unfortunately, we're having winner's finals on off stream.
Yeah, it's all right. Watch this godlike play of Kotal Kahn.
And the last for Takeda.
Okay.
Right now, JD is down around, but he's...
He wakes up. Win. Yeah, see, I just... It's so... Oh, he does it so much that you just don't do it, you know? Just block. Kotal doesn't really have traditional 50-50 mix-ups to start with, I should say. So just blocking is not a bad idea, and then armoring through gaps. No punish, though. That's neutral. The jump back. He's going to confirm? Yes, he is. Okay, good damage.
32%.
Yeah, Lasher probably does the least damage of the three, but he still does pretty decent. Nice. It's going to be a full combo. 26 meterless. Push him to the corner. No bar. Plus frames. Does the overhead. Yeah. Don't jump away. Where are you going?
Has him in the corner. Wow. Oh, wake
see,
up
okay.
Grab.
That's much better. Because everyone's waiting on JD to wake up armor. So just mix it up a
you
little.
You mean Dust?
Yeah, Dust. I'm sorry. Nice. Again with the forward one.
Doesn't put him back in the corner. Breaks. I don't know about that.
Yeah, it wasn't a great idea. He was trying to avoid that Kotal situation. But, I mean, the combo was over. But he can run it back.
Whoa.
Isn't confirming into anything. Yeah, there it is. He missed the punish on the overhead sword. Lasher can do the scoop. Punish him every time. Scoop. That wasn't a punish, but whatever. We'll take it. Okay.
You know what's weird? That whip is a mid, but the characters act like it's a low. Like they make that movement like it's a low.
Yeah, that was a good combo by JD, actually. Sometimes he does an unoptimized version.
Wake up throw again, the ATP tech is what
he
calls
it. Yeah, that thing's godlike, dude. Wake up throw is godlike. Sonic Fox tech is the wake up jump out. That's why he wins tournaments.
Oh.
You heard it here first. Doesn't commit. I disagree. He should have spent the bar there. Nice dodge.
Over the
yeah, but
and
that was
JD takes the game. It is 1-1.
Sticking with Takeda, though. No Molina.
I guess this is for Pride. Checking to see whose
character
is better.
You want Izzy to play next? Okay, you'll play the winner.
Oh, man. Stream. I got a long drive home.
You were tired.
I know. I don't know. I know why I'm tired.
Why don't you carpool with? Because
I don't
carpool?
Know when they're coming.
Oh.
And they come here like right at 7. So
yeah, that's true.
I like to get here early.
Yeah, bums. Get on it.
I leave my house at 3:30, bro.
Damn, really? You a boss like that?
I have to get out. First I don't want to get traffic, but I always end up hitting traffic. And
nice armor.
Man, by the time I get here, it's like 5:15.
Yeah, I know.
So.
Sorry, dude. I might come to San Antonio in October.
For what?
I'm just going to come to play Marvel, but if y'all are there to play MK,
Marvel.
I'll come play also.
Yeah, I just found out Ultra Arcade has weekly Street Fighters on Thursdays. I'm going to start going out.
Oh, that overhead was too far. Okay, so he's got him in the corner, but Dust is fighting his way out.
It's
a punish. No, he's got a punish with the low scoot every time. Even if it isn't the meter burn
nice
one
jump.
For a full combo. It's going to be a full confirm.
What was that? 32% meterless.
He's
going to
wake up. There,
ooh.
See? Much better to just use it in situations like that.
Down
just down
two.
Two.
Wake up, down two.
Don't even think
the
about
dust,
it.
The dust tech.
Yeah, if you're just smarter with your armor use, dust would be much better placing.
Yes, he does. He confirms
yeah, I
it.
Agree. Get the space. Takeda
he
wins at
30,
this range.
32%. Keeps yeah. trying to keep him away. Low
just
Kunai.
Wait for, there it is. Exactly.
The dust gets the game.
Okay.
Now we're on game 4. Oh, armors gets the first bar.
Yeah, that armor is not safe, but it can be tricky. Whoa, just stand 3.
The big boot.
Okay, catches
21%.
Him. JD got to the corner position right now, but puts himself there. I disagree. It's going to break. Catches the jump back.
Wow.
Kotal is maybe the best character in the game at doing that. Catching jump backs. With the forward one string with the overhead sword. Very good. Plus frames. Okay. JD's playing patient. Yeah, he catches him.
Has him in the corner.
Very nice. JD just bullied Dust the whole way to the corner,
basically. He's going to try to keep him in the corner. Dust probably going to try to space him out. Back two, but doesn't convert.
Jump in. Okay, he's got to put him back in, though.
Let's see if he does. And he does. Very good. 41%. Wow.
Yeah, Kotal, he does damage if he can get an air grab combo, but it's not very common.
Oh, no. Some armor.
Okay, so the wake up armor works this time. Getting some space, throwing interactables, yeah, trying to zone him out. Uh oh. Okay.
That's super.
It was too respectful there, actually. He could have backed one. Again, super respectful. He's waiting for that wake up armor from Dust. And Dust isn't giving it to him. Nice.
Out of the air.
Okay, Dust can't take this. He has the space. Doesn't do the full string.
Oh,
doesn't confirm. Does a switch stance. That's going to be it.
Dust
was a little ugly.
Set point.
A little ugly there at the end, but he clutches it out. He has a bar. JD. Wow, overhead sword.
Yep.
Oh, and he does the air, anti-air armor. Okay, he has him in the corner. This is Dust's chance. Catches him. That's fine. Plus, he's being way too respectful. Okay. Yeah, Dust didn't have bar there. Let's see what he does.
Wait, Dust. Throw. I'm telling you. He was waiting for that armor.
Yeah, exactly. If Dust just chilled with the armor a little bit, he'd have a much better mind game on Waco.
You're trying to back away?
The he does the overhead. Work. See, jump back. Very tough to deal with sometimes. 50-50s. That was risky.
Oh, no.
Okay, that all comboed. JD
Oh, he had to break. JD is on the verge of getting eliminated.
He was trying to press probably armor at any time, and there was no chance. This is bad. Yeah,
oh,
nice blocks.
But,
no conversion. Okay, wow, nice there. And there's the armor.
Oh,
just down two.
That is.
Dust takes
Dust
it.
Takes the game.
All right, Izzy's going to have to hop off. His Melina's not at that level.
You know, I was setting you up to say that. Yeah. I hope that
that's fine. None
this.
Of us, none of our characters are at the true level to represent how ridiculous they are.
But Dust gets the first hit.
He's
going
to break immediately. That's one of Piercing's strengths. Always has breaker, builds a ton of bar, all the size, all the back 1-2s. But Izzy counter pokes. Okay, he's going to get good damage. Has a bar.
Oh, these teleports.
Okay. Okay. Waiting for
a
roll,
we jumped
I think.
Back, no punish?
And no punish. That was nasty. Nice confirm, though.
Yeah, it was a good anti-air.
Yeah. All right. Again, two bars on Dust's side. So any hit, yeah, straight into breaker. I agree. Nice teleport. That had to be a read. You can't react to those size. And he takes the plus 20 kunai.
Even characters with reflex can't react to the psi. It's terrible.
It's hard, man. And even if you reflect it, like the straight one, she can just do the low one and punish a lot
right,
of characters
exactly.
for it. So... That's why she's a top 5 zoner and a top 5 footsie character. It's a little too much. But anyway, it just goes into the roll. Doesn't confirm.
He was believing,
is he
going to
spend bar? Yes, he is. All right, is it going to be 35?
Dust is a man of faith.
Okay. Goes for the meaty kunai. Catches him. Nice confirm. Wow, he went YOLO with that.
Dust just needs to start blocking a little bit more.
Yeah,
Izzy's
he blocks one of these teleports and Izzy will get his pants caught down. He whiffs the string, but doesn't do a full.
He could have woke up with a roll and got
yeah,
a lot more damage.
Just down two is not going to cut it. He's going to try and make the comeback.
Or is he going to lay down?
Yeah, this back 1-2 pressure. As he pokes out, plus kunai, nothing he can do about it. He's dead.
Yep, that is death.
Shira Ryu, man. It's good.
It's pretty lame.
Finger licking good.
Pretty lame. Can't wait for it to get nerfed.
Hey, don't worry. Yours is getting nerfed, too.
Who?
Yours.
Ronan?
Yeah, dude. Are you kidding me?
Ronan's going to go untouched, friend.
Shut up. Jesus Christ. Ronan definitely has got to get nerfed on the sword drop frames.
Nah,
yes.
It's cool.
You leaving? Oh, okay.
It's good to see you, man.
You want
to
maybe play this week? Okay. I'll shoot you a text. But anyway, Izzy mode decides to break. Whoa, double teleports. That's actually something that you can do. Does not do the cancel.
Could you punish the standing Psy that he just did?
Yeah. The standing Psy is like minus 10. It's probably hard for Takeda.
It's hard for Takeda, for sure.
You're going to do like stand 1.
He would have to do stand 1, and the pushback's just not going to happen.
So, but Izzy mode kind of choking this up right now. There's the neutral jump. He can win this with the EX. Yeah, there it is. I like it.
No.
Oh, we dropped it.
Oh, my God.
So, why is Izzy mode not playing Kung Jin? Why would he not play his main?
Kung Jin? So... I don't know if maybe he just feels that Kung Jin loses to Lasher, and then this is just
okay.
What Dust shows the pick.
So we've seen two counter picks, basically.
Yeah. I honestly don't think Kung Jin necessarily loses, but it can be an issue with the jump back two and the giant back two normals on the ground. Kung Jin can't jump as freely as he would like. So he's not getting that teleport cancel at all. But Dust is really not making him pay. Nice confirm off the low. Hicks hit my overhead, though. Okay. That was okay damage. Okay, he gets the cancel
there. Yeah,
there's
a cancel.
And he catches the teleport. Yeah, it was weird. She was in the ground, basically.
Another drop.
Nice. Okay, Dust has to break again. Izzy has the advantage. No, he doesn't have stamina,
he's
but
gotta block Dust.
Dust still gets hit, and that's going to be the round. Never mind.
Wow. Blocking will go so far.
Yeah.
Izzy's up 2-0.
Punches her in the face. Yeah, Dust, I mean, I know he's trying to work on this Melina, but it is definitely not ready.
I would like to see a Takeda Mirror. Lasher versus Shirai Ryu. That'd be fun.
That's all.
Plus still. Frames upon plus frames.
Yeah. Well, Lasher's got the...
he's got the kunai.
He does have the
he's
kunai.
Got the kunai. It's all we need.
You know,
I
was actually... I was thinking
kunai
the other
the
day,
one.
I was looking at the roster, and I was like, if we did a variationless tier list, who would be the best? And I had Alien and Jax as top tier, because they're basically the same. And then I had Takeda right there at number 3.
Johnny loses his cancels.
Johnny loses everything, yeah. He's trash. Kotal's trash. He doesn't even get the parry. He literally just has air grab and pizza.
He doesn't get the overhead sword.
No, he doesn't get anything. Quan is okay.
Plus Scorpion.
Scorpion's honestly like Inferno, basically. So it's kind of trash.
Inferno's good, man.
Yeah, whatever.
Dude, we didn't see it on stream, but Ruben almost eliminated or almost beat Abram in the first round.
Inferno's trash.
Anyway, it looks like Dust didn't switch. He's sticking with piercing.
Yeah. So let's see.
I don't know why.
Yeah, he misspaced the crap
would,
out of that.
I would
low,
definitely switch to Lasher.
Oh wow, Lantern is
like, there's not anything you're gonna learn in this kind of matchup since she's gonna get nerfed. There's gonna be so many changes.
Yeah. The I mean, this matchup is fairly even. I don't think necessarily Melina wins. Okay, Izzy mode, getting something going here. Gonna do the hard to blockable. Yeah, it's very hard to stop. Match point, Izzy. So wait, you want to do Rage and Abram on stream? Yeah, do that. Do Rage and Abram on stream, and then I'll play Izzy on this setup here. We have to. No, I'm not saying me on stream. I'm saying I'll play on this setup here.
Right, but I'm saying we have time to wait for
them. Yeah, this match is basically over. I mean, I'm sorry, but Dust.
You're up next.
Yeah, Dust doesn't, his confirms aren't quite there. Rage is just there waiting for him. Dust's confirms aren't quite there, and if you don't take advantage of all the crazy damage Melina has.
No, on stream, when they're done. When they're done.
Yeah, and then right now, Izzy has 3 bars. He gets caught overhead like a dummy.
Basically done, huh? Don't count
well, okay,
Dust
okay, okay.
out yet.
If Dust wins, then we'll move him to the other side.
Sure we will.
Wow, he did down. Ooh.
Dust, prove this man wrong.
Oh my god.
This man has counted
you
out. You
can't do that.
Good blocking.
That's
no punish.
And that was a terrible punish.
It was a terrible punish. It was an MK9
roll.
Punish.
You have to understand when you don't have stamina, you cannot do the teleport.
I don't think Izzy mode understands that.
Yeah,
I don't think he knows what a stamina bar is.
Yeah. It's just wow,
just
air teleporting.
I want to see more neutral from Dust. Better neutral play.
Yeah, it's just it's.
He's jumping and
it's
not
quite
blocking.
Not, it's not quite there. This might be the round.
Yeah, this is gonna. Not
He'll be alive, but he's gonna have to make the right read here. Okay, gets out.
A terrible interactable
two.
Works.
Oh, that might be a jump in. Doesn't do the overhead roll. That was the chance. Overhead roll.
Ooh! This man is not out.
He had to do overhead roll. Yeah. I was like, just do overhead roll, overhead roll. All
right, go
all right Dust wins. In our hearts. Easy mode actually advances in the tournament.
So they are locked in. Rage has locked into Devorah. I didn't see what variation. It's probably Swarm Queen. Broodmother, interesting. Shoutouts to the clan Lord winning. The Devorah of Austin. Or not Austin. Well, yeah, Austin. He's an Austin homie. Of Texas. Yes, thank you. Okay. So unlike what we saw from Izzy a set ago, Senior Abrams' teleport cancels are crisp. Look at these teleports. Look at these air teleports. So I think Senior Abrams just content on keeping Rage at bay with his giant normals. They whiffed that, though. No punish from Rage, though. Good uppercut that time. He gets a punish there. got to be a little bit more patient. There was no reason to use bar, definitely, on Rage's part. You're going to want to save your bar, because when you get caught in that Shirai Ryu blender, you're going to need that breaker. Okay, some respect from Rage. He's really trying to figure this out, trying to figure out when to press buttons, what to do. He's getting hit by a lot of things right now, though. He's getting hit overhead, he's getting hit low, and that's game one. Wow. I don't think Rage is ready for this. All right, we're going back in. Right, Rage is being a little bit more aggressive. He's got to mind the backdash, though. I really do think that Broodmother, you just need to rush down Shirai Ryu. You don't want Shirai Ryu to get started. Good stuff from Rage right now. He's got the pressure going on. And you know, this is interesting. Not a lot of people play against Broodmother, have experience against Broodmother. Senior Abrams is very intelligent when it comes to this game. He has a lot of knowledge. But does he have the Broodmother knowledge? Because he is getting hit right now by the bugs. Or he was. Wake up uppercut from Rage. Rage holds it good, but he doesn't. It's hard to block him for a reason. Oh, he jumps out. Good stuff. And he almost converts for a full combo. He gets hit. Delayed wake up. Good option by Rage. Ooh, look at this. We have a set. Oh, wow. No punish there. I wonder what Senior Abram was thinking. Okay. Oh, wow. He gets hit by the kunai. Ooh. Frisky stuff from Senior Abram. Oh, wow. A low. There we go. Uh-oh. Side switch. Rage is in the corner. Good blocks from Rage. Just going to try and jump in. Not quite there. Good stuff. Uses the crawling. Ooh, look at this punish. Senior Abram's letting Rage jump a little bit too much, but Rage is... Combos are pretty good. I've never seen Rage play Broodmother, but he's doing really well. He chases down the backdash. Look at that. Oh, the names are wrong. Let me switch the names. I believe it. I believe you were scared of Cutthroat. Is it? I'm gonna assume that was 3-0. Yeah. Embarrassing. No, what did he do?
Like, after the first game, he just took out his... Or in the middle of the second game, he took out his head and was like, I'm going to lose.
Oh, my God. So ATP advances. Izzy mode is eliminated. Hey, Andres, while you're waiting, what you should do is you should play Ruben in the...
Yeah, but they're going to play
second. Yeah, but I'm just saying.
Yeah.
All right. We really got to get this going, though. So it is 1-1. Senior Abram is up around on game 3. Gets the hit. Rage not blocking on wake up. Good blocks. He blocks both lows this time. Hits him with a projectile. He gets the punish! I love it. It may be an uppercut, but at least it's something. You know? I'm sure you can get like a stand one punish into full combo. Senior Abram is up 2-1. Want to see a fatality.
Oh, KI is the best. You ever want to just relax, play, just have fun?
Right. So, I don't feel like that was a bad pick, actually. Broodmother. Broodmother has good tools. Devorah, base Devorah in general, has good tools. I feel like that was working out okay for Rage. Just, you know, made a couple of wrong decisions. But he is going back to his main, which is Jax. Heavy weapons Jax at that. We're seeing more heavy weapons today. Lots of Jax today. Between Poser, Paul, and Rage. Good stuff. Usually we see all three variations of Takedo, which we actually have seen. Ronan, Shirai, Ryu, and Lasher. Seen all three of Jax. No anti-air there from Rage. Ooh, a little too far away. I think Rage definitely read the backdash, but it just the spacing wasn't there. Oh, wow, he didn't expect Kunai there. Ooh, low. Gets a hit confirm. He has the corner. He's got one bar to work with. I think he should save it, though. Let's wait until he gets another hit, though. Ooh, he gets a hit. No, ooh, he gets a hit. Okay, Abram breaks. This is good for Rage. Even though Abram is up around, and he is on set point, actually, Rage doesn't have to think about that. Don't think about that. Just focus on the fact that you've got Abram to use both his bars there. Good stuff. Good dash punch. This is actually a good pick. I think this is a really good pick for Rage. Excellent. Going back to his main. Gets the hit confirm. Maybe could have done a little bit more, but that's okay. Ooh, reaches the back dash, does a machine gun. Beautiful. Beautiful stuff. I love seeing that machine gun. We don't see it enough. Punished. Yes. Whip punished that man. Ooh, look at the trades. This is good. Rage is pressing all the right buttons now. I don't know about that, though. Yes, good trade. Don't block when you can trade. Come on. Ooh, Abram just gets hit. Interesting. Rage just has to play patient. Just has to block. He tries to jump over, which is fair. It's a good try. Rage used two bars to get out of that situation. I don't know about this. I don't know about this. Wow. All right, man. Have a good night. Bye. All right. Do some homework. Thank you. Ooh, good hit. Oh, good block, but no punish. You can punish that with forward one, but he didn't even bother. He went for the slower overhead. 15 frames compared to 10. And ATP is going in. Okay. Uses the bar. One of the cool things about this game is that even though there's so many characters and so many variations, like 100 characters basically, not only that, but just think about one variation. And there's multiple ways to play even one variation. And Ronan is a good example of that. You know, you look at the way Senior Abram plays. You look at the way Hayate plays. Look at the way Groller Bears plays. They all play differently, which is just really cool. Speaks a lot. Says a lot about the game. Senior Abram's up one round in game one. Good armor. Good combo. We got the sword back. HP not having it. He has the Ronin experience. He's played Abram many a times too. All right. I think Abram took that. Well, wow. Okay, game two. These players usually go back and forth. I know ATP defeated Abram twice in two of our weeklies to win. And then Abram's kind of come back and had the upper hand. I think Abram won the last time. Ooh, whiffs the back one and gets hit by ATP. Ooh, interesting. I think he thought ATP was going to go in, but it didn't quite work. Whiffs the DP. ATP's got to get around all these swords, all these shenanigans here. A fair character against a broke character. That's what they say. Ooh, was that a punish? I don't think that was a punish. But that was smart to go with the overhead from Abram. Armor's through again. He's going to expose all those gaps. No hit confirm from Abram. Down three is a little off. He's whiffing some strings here. Not good. Kotal's good at whiff punishing. HP's got a good life lead. Text the grab. Excellent. Good stuff. Down one will do it. But now he starts the round on the lightsaber. He's going to block that. We all know that. So he's got to respect Abram as he comes in. And now Abram has corner position. Ooh. Ooh. I think Abram was reading that grab. Good low. No armor this time from Abram. Even though he has three bars. Trying to jump out, not quite working. He's got to do something. Expose more gaps. Ooh! My mind games on mind games. So usually after the X sword, Kotal Kahn players will go in for pressure. ATP knew that Abram was going to try and armor through the pressure, so he just waited, and he killed him. Good stuff. This is, we're getting to really high-level play here now for our matches this week. Good stuff. You stay by the low. Excellent. It's 21-frame startup, but it doesn't matter. You expect the overhead. You're waiting for that. You're going to get opened up with that low. Starts on the blade. No, he gets the blade back. Wow. Abram's so good. I'm so jelly. As a Ronin main, I'm very jelly right now. Abram is very good. He's definitely taught me a handful of things. Along with Roller Bears, shout out to both of them. Shout outs to both of them, Abram and Roller Bears. Teaching me some things. Teaching a scrub like me. Ooh, risky from Abram. Sunlight. Fun stuff. Backdash from Abram. Ooh, ATP gets hit waking up. I don't know if maybe he tried waking up with backdash, but that's not going to work. So this is game three, and Abram is up by one round. Good hit. HP gets some good hits here. I don't know why Abram used that armor. I think he was expecting something else and just had his mind ready on it. But that's going to be round for ATP. Okay, gets the sword back. Smart move. ATP not quite respecting the range on the normals. On the whip normals. Good blocks from ATP. This is going to be a solid punish. Back one punish is good. That's going to work. Going to get all that damage. 33 plus frames. HP's trying to press buttons. Okay, this is really close right now. Abram just disrespecting and waking up with the overhead. He's going to use all three of these bars. He could kill. If he did Hayate combos, he could kill. But he didn't. And the round is still going. Still pretty much even. What will we see? We're going to see ATP letting Abram kill himself. ATP runs up because he knows that after the breaker, he's going to be on top of the lightsaber. Or I guess that was a dash up. Good stuff. ATP takes it. 2-1. Not over yet, though. They just take that game. So, on the Austin tier list, at least, this might be true in general, though. We don't know yet. Unstoppable Jason is actually higher on the tier list than Kotal. I wonder if Unstoppable Jason has tools to fight Kotal, because Abram does play, as I talked about, really good Jason. But it doesn't matter right now, because he's locked in to Ronin, and ATP's on set point. That was a quick set point, too. Okay, Senior Abram trying to create space, but Abram is just, or HP is just kind of going in. Down four. Okay. Abram using that bar. Good stuff. Ooh, no hit confirm from Abram. But he does have a good life lead here. Ooh, was that a trip guard using the last hit? He whipped the first two hits of the string, but he went for the last hit. I think he trip guarded ATP. Wow, wake up grab. The balls on this man. The rolling safe balls on this man. This is really good. Both players have full bar. Good hit. Catching ATP trying to press buttons. He knows ATP's going to respect that sword, so Abram gets free pressure. Down one check. Ooh, the back one one armor breaks. Now ATP has used all of his resources, and Abram hasn't used any of his bars. Oh, no confirm. That's okay, though. He's trying to run him to the other side. Will we see a Blanchality? Will we see a Blanchality? Jump in. Good blocks. Exposes the gap. Ooh, uppercut from ATP. He's good with those. He will anti-air you all day. Oh, that's plus. And Abram knew it. Abram knew that ATP knew. And Abram takes that. It's 2-2. Will we get out of here on time? Probably not. That's okay. Okay, uses that armor to get out of the corner. Good option. Okay. HP tries to run in, but Abram catches him. Drop, though. ATP's just... But he's raging a little bit on the inside, having to hold all this stuff. He's always complaining about Ronin. Even though he beats my Ronin all day. Okay. HP gets the air to air, he's going to take that round. Good stuff. Good read. Good hit. I don't know if ATP is trying to wake up with a bar but didn't have one, or if he's trying to wake up with backdash, but he got hit. He's going to let Abram just call back that sword. Okay. Tries to go for the jump four. HP again is going to anti-air him. HP is on set point, by the way. Will we see the end of Abram being eliminated before we get to any kind of final rounds? Losers finals, grand finals, winners finals. This week, will it be Abram's week? He's got to stay out of that light. That light's going to kill. He's just building meter. That's going to do it. Alright, so this is Losers Finals. Welcome to Losers Finals. Sorry I was taking a restroom break there, but I'm glad these guys got started because we got about 19 minutes left before our venue closes. But this is Losers Finals. ATP going out with a bang with Alien, using Alien. Probably the last chance he can get, definitely the last chance he can get in tournament before Alien gets hit with that Nerf Mop. Tries to anti-air, and he's going with Tarkatan. Tarkatan has been the variation of choice for ATP. And I tell you what, you know, just kind of thinking about this matchup real quick, I'm pretty sure that Quan Chi is pretty effed. Pretty effed. I kind of wish Mr. Knowledge would go Sorcerer against Alien. I don't know, maybe. But he's been playing a lot of Warlock. I know he can play all variations, but he's been playing only Warlock today, so maybe he's just trying to level up a little bit. Maybe he thinks Warlock's going to be the most viable after next week, and so he's just playing that. ATP going ham on Knowledge right now. Alright, ATP takes the first game. I didn't even have to look at that blunder, because you know it's a blunder. HP's making quick work. I think that's what he's doing. He's trying to make really quick work of his last victims to try and get us out of here. And Alien can do it. All right, now it gets the raw scoop. Tries to air tear, but he's not going to beat Alien's no hurt box Baraka blades. Okay, HP backing off. Gonna get that whiff punish. No, I think normally HP has Knowledge's number, but last week at our tournament, Knowledge did beat ATP. So right now, just basically just he should just lie down on his back and take it. There's really nothing he can do here. He gets a grab though. Overhead, low, gonna go for the rune. Good air to air. Good read on Nauj. What kind of setup are we gonna see? Okay, goes for the meter build. This won't kill. Gonna have to hit him one more time. Ooh, the reads! One read after another, so good. Oh, his name is wrong. Excuse me, don't let me butcher that. Oh, ATP, he's going for the kill here. This will kill. Ooh, no, interesting. But, didn't matter. He's dead now. Yeah, he could have killed, but he chose not to, I guess. Okay. Starts with the overhead. Quanchi's on his back again. Going in for pressure. If you're guessing on Nauj's part. Nauj gets the trance. Oh, wow. Yeah, that's a punish. That's minus 14. This is a regular rune. ATP's, looking good. Set point ATP. Be right back. All right. Very generous with People's Anime in Austin to host us. We are running late today. Sometimes we run late. And they are usually okay with it, so thank you. Shout out to Oopals. Right now, Alien's on his back. Nauj runs in, gets the grab. No 50-50s here. I'm just going to grab you. And a rare no grab tech from ATP. Interesting choice of Ender. I really don't know what that was about. Nauj gets the hit. And just goes for the uppercut. Wow. Stare down. No teabag, though. Would have liked to have seen a teabag. This might be now just first round that he's won. I don't know. I just know this is terrible. There's the Baraka spin. And right now, Nauj is already at a 50% deficit. This is terrible. Oh, I guess hit by the infamous overhead. That overhead's probably going to turn to a mid after the patch. Okay. Tricky stuff. Down four. Down four and low. Down four and overhead. Nauj gets the hit. His life is on the line here, but he does have a bar, so he can make this stuff work. Goes for a fancy reset. ATP's not biting. And that's it. Alright, he pretty much freed up ATP earlier in the bracket. ATP had no excuse, he just played bad. So good on him for... He lost fair and square, good on him for recognizing that. We're gonna go into it though. ATP is going with Alien. His last tournament life. He's gonna stick with Alien before the nerfs hit him hard. Now, earlier in tournament, when Hinzar beat ATP, it was ATP was using War God, and Hinzar was using Grandmaster. But I think Hinzar has counterpicked Tarkatan with Cryomancer, which we have found has been a pretty decent counterpick, actually. Oh yeah, Dust, you don't mind, like, just taking that apart. Just be careful not to unplug the wrong console. Okay, cool. Oh yeah, sorry. If you could watch it, that's fine. Don't let me be your boss. And Hinzar's gonna take. Is it gonna kill? Yeah, it's gonna kill because it's cryo. He's gonna take first game. Yep. Crowd doesn't need buffs. We should be done pretty quick. Okay. Sorry. All right, good backdash. My hands are. Knockdown. All right. He's just gonna use a bar to anti-air. Gets the combo though. Not a bad option. Zara's pressing too many buttons here. HP gets the hit. Another knockdown. Doesn't block that low. Oh! Good wake up though. Alright, another good anti-air. He's gonna send him to the other side? No. I guess he can't in this variation. Yeah, he gets the restand instead of the body toss. Again, HP getting hit by the low in that string. We saw him get hit by that a couple times in their last set earlier in the tournament. Enzar is sitting pretty good here. Again, he is on winner's side, so all the pressure's on ATP. Enzar is making some good moves here. Good stuff, but ATP uses armor of his own. Armor air roll. It's probably safe too. Look at the wake up. You gotta know Hinzar is gonna wake up. Good stuff. 1-0. Zara's got good corner position. Goes for a restand. Interesting. How did HP get hit with that ice ball? Whiffing all these normals. And Zara's just backing up, playing so smart. His spacing's really good. Good stuff. Yeah, good stand one anti-air. Get the restand into hammer again. Builds. Oh, ATP just got hit by it. Okay. ATP's getting hit by everything here. Maybe he is drunk. Maybe he's still hungover. Wow. What the hell? Even ATP admits he got mopped. Mopped with an ice hammer. This is kind of pathetic, not gonna lie. Good blocks from Hinzar, too. And armoring through the gap. This is next level Hinzar here. Yeah, look at the blocks and the gap. Okay, there we go. Good stuff from ATP. Just running up. Because I'm going to armor whatever you throw at me. Almost got him with the forward one. Again, good blocks from Hinzar. These guys have played so often. I know Hinzar still has nightmares, losing to HP's alien time after time after time. Oh, drops the combo though. Gets the hit. No convert. That's fine. Oh, doesn't block the overhead this time. Good slide. Yeah! Oh, no, to punish! He does it again! Why would you do it again? Oh my god. Hinzar's on set point here in our grand finals. Good hit. Doesn't block that one. That would have been a lot of good damage if he could have blocked that. Was that backdash recovery, maybe? Or was he pressing buttons? This is ATP's round here. And it looks like he's going to start the next round of the corner, too. See if Hinzar can get out. Nah, the chip. Ooh, what is this? Not in the corner. That is right. Hinzar somehow got out. Woke up with a grab. I was definitely gonna read a jump in or a jump over. Okay, both players running at each other. Ooh, he can convert. ATP is just looking so sloppy right now. Oh, Hinzar just gets hit. Yeah, break that. That's a good break. Okay, good trip guard. Overhead. It's gonna be safe. HP is about to take this. Oh, he woke up, but he didn't wake up with slide. He woke up with a hammer. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Definitely a little more blocking. That's good. 2-1. Ooh, I don't know if that was an accident or not, but it sure didn't come in handy. And you're not going to jump over the alien roll. Good slide. Wake up slide. Hits him. Gets the confirm. I don't know what that overhead was, but it was there. HP wakes up with more armor. This is looking really bad. I see Hinzar kind of slow down a little bit and block a little more of these wake ups. It's okay, though. It's going to be a guess either way. Grab. He takes that round. Another set point for Hinzar. Round two. Fight. Okay. Backdash. Yeah, again, another wake up from ATP. Mixed up with Rekka's this time. Good block. Gonna get a punish. Step back. Finish the combo. Drops it, though. Unfortunate. Highly unfortunate. Lin Kuei is disappointed. This is your grandmaster? Come on. Oh, no reason to use armor there. Oh, he was blocking, but he was blocking low. You telling me Cryomancer has a 50-50 wake-up game? Nuts. Round 3. Game 4. Pot is out of play. Good anti-air. Hinzar slow in the air-to-air. Blocks from ATP. But Hinzar still wants his turn. What are we gonna see? Safe stuff. Keep it safe. It's okay. He didn't block the low. That's okay. Oh no. Why would you slide? You had corner position. You had a good life lead. And you just slid. What's Hinzar gonna do here? Down one check from ATP. Good tech. ATP gets hit by the low again. Wasn't ready. Oh no. Waste the bar. A tricky low. Good break. Is Hinzar gonna finish this off? He's slowing things down a little bit. ATP's gotta find a way in. Gets hit! What? Why did that ice ball not work? Oh, there we go, though. Hinzar is unfazed, and he takes it. And we get the fatality. Long time coming. Congratulations, Hinzar.